Welcome to the course UVC001. In previous module, we have discussed another biasing method, that is of my emitter bias, now which is termed as voltage divider bias. This technique is also known as self bias. This technique is also known as self-bias technique. Okay, so let me draw the circuit diagram first for the understanding. And as far as the complexity concern, so it has the most complicated circuit in comparison to the previous two. Means more hardware is required to design this type of biasing. But as far as the practical application concern, this is most widely used, and mathematically we will see all such proofs. So this is my VCC input we will apply over here. See, our two series resistances R1 and R2, load resistance RC, feedback resistance RE. We will use one coupling capacitor C0, we will measure output from here, and one more capacitor is connected, which is termed as my emitter bypass capacitor. So this is termed as CE, which is my emitter bypass capacitor, and this is my voltage divider bias circuit. So further, in order to do the analysis, we require its DC equivalent circuit. And in the DC equivalent circuit, simply replace capacitors by open circuit. So let me draw the circuit, and I will do some arrangements so that the circuit can be easily understand and one can easily apply KVL to the input and output loops. So I have connected VCC so that the output loop can be formed. So this is my VCC, load resistance RC, emitter resistance RE, and now you can check resistance R2. I am connecting as it is. However, this resistance R1, I am connecting resistance R1 over here in series with a supply of VCC. So this is my DC equivalent circuit. This is my VCC, resistance R1, resistance R2. Okay, and all. So this is the junction point. Whatever be the junction point over here, this is my junction point. And as far as the current concern, I will have base current over here, IB, I over current IC, current IE, and this is my base to emitter voltage VBE. This voltage is VCE. So this is my final DC equivalent circuit for voltage divider bias configuration. Okay, so for the analysis of this circuit, there are two methods. One is known as the exact method, and second one is approximate method. So there is one condition which is known as the condition of approximation. If that condition meet out, then one can solve the same circuit using approximate method. Otherwise, there is the exact method. So let's start our discussion with the exact method first. So as far as the exact analysis concern, we need to use one network theorem. Whose name is the Thevenin theorem. So this says that for any complicated network, so let me explain in the form of block diagram. Suppose I am having a complicated network. So a complicated network can be replaced by a circuit if this complicated network has connected one load resistance, and suppose this is my load resistance RL, then it can be replaced by a Thevenin equivalent voltage source of value VTH in series with Thevenin equivalent resistance, and it is connected to a load. So for any linear and bilateral circuit, we can apply this. Thevenin's theorem says that any complicated network can be converted to this network. So let me see the first step, how to calculate the RTH. Number one, replace all the energy sources by their internal resistance. Now what it means. So if I am having a voltage source, replace it by a short circuit. However, if I am having a current source, replace it by open circuit. I am covering this theorem in detail because there is a utilization for the analysis of same problem. So replace all energy sources by their internal resistance. And now remove the load resistance. Remove the load resistance from the network. The equivalent resistance, the equivalent resistance across the open circuited terminals is known as my Thevenin equivalent resistance. Let us discuss the next part, how to calculate VTH, the load from the network, and the next part, determine the open circuit voltage, Thevenin equivalent voltage. Okay, so whatever be the open circuit voltage, the same is my Thevenin equivalent voltage. Okay, so now let us do this method. Okay, the exact analysis. So first I am drawing the network, and then I will draw its equivalent, Thevenin equivalent. So if you can recall, my DC equivalent circuit for voltage divider bias This was a circuit where one more resistance R2 was connected. So this is my VCC, resistance R1, this is resistance RC, resistance R2, where it is resistance RE, and this is my VCC. So over here I am saying that this particular segment is my load. So if I am removing that particular part temporarily, then my network becomes R1, R2, and now I am having the open terminals. For the simplicity, I am marking this is my terminal A, this is my terminal B. So that is R2, that is R1, and VCC. For the calculation of VTH, what to do? I have to find the open circuit voltage. That means VAB is my VTH, and you can check VAB is voltage across resistance R2. Now we will use voltage division rule. You can apply voltage VTH equals to R2 into VCC divided by R1 plus R2. So that is my VTH. Now next, for the calculation of RTH, what is the method? Replace energy source by their internal resistance and voltage source by short circuit. So let me draw the circuit first for that. So I have replaced this by short circuit, resistance R1, resistance R2, and these are my open terminal, and I have to look from the open circuit terminal. So it seems that my RTH equals to R1 parallel R2. That means my RTH equals to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So now my network is solved. In place of this circuit, now I can simply place a voltage source, value VTH, a series resistance RTH, and I am showing these are my open terminals A and B. And across terminal AB, I want to draw my load once again. Okay, so my final circuit is something like this. This is my resistance RTH, which we have just solved. This is my VTH. We have just determined its value. And this is my VCC. So RC, RP, and here it is VTH. And in fact, if you can see that we have just calculated my RTHs. R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This VTH is R2 VCC divided by R1 plus R2. Current flowing over here is my IB. Current flowing over here is my IC. Current flowing over here is IE. Voltage across here is VCE. And voltage across here is VBE. So this is the circuit for voltage divider biasing after applying the Thevenin theorem. So this is my final circuit, and if you can see, if you can compare this circuit, then you can check this circuit is almost same as that of the circuit which we have discussed in case of emitter bias, and there is only one difference. This VTH was over there termed as my VCC, and this RTH was termed by my RB. So this is the only difference. Okay, so I am writing the value of stability factor and all directly. Stability factor for exact analysis will be equals to 1 plus beta divided by 1 plus बीटा टाइम्स ऑफ आर ई डिवाइडेड बाय आर ई प्लस आर टी एच, वेयर वन कैन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर टी एच. सो दिस इज द ओनली डिफरेंस बिटवीन द स्टेबिलिटी फैक्टर फॉर्मूला. एंड लाइकवाइज आई एम राइटिंग द फॉर्मूला फॉर आई बी ऑल्सो. आई बी इक्वल्स टू वी टी एच. नाउ रादर देन माइनस वी सी सी माइनस वी बी, इट इज वी टी एच माइनस वी टी ई डिवाइडेड बाय इट इज आर टी एच प्लस वन प्लस बीटा टाइम्स ऑफ आर सी प्लस आर ई. सो दिस इज माई इनपुट करंट आई बी. नाउ वन कैन ऑल्सो इजिली सॉल्व, वन कैन ऑल्सो इजिली सॉल्व फॉर करंट आई सी विच विल बी इक्वल टू बीटा टाइम्स ऑफ आई बी एंड करंट आई ई इक्वल टू वन प्लस बीटा टाइम्स ऑफ आई बी. So I have directly written that term because we have already performed the derivation, okay, in the previous biasing method. In fact, for load line analysis, the term is same. Apply KVL to the output loop. Considering IC is approximately equal to IE, so this will provide us VCE equals to VCC minus IC times of RC plus RE. So we will have the two points. I am directly writing the point VCC and 0, and second point is my 0 and VCC divided by RC plus RE. So it is same as that of emitter bias. So I'm not drawing because we have already discussed in detail. Now let us see the another method, which is termed as the approximate analysis. Let us discuss now approximate analysis. And it termed as, there is a condition of approximation. And it is, if beta times RE is greater than or equals to 10 times of R2, if this condition is satisfied, and what it means, this means that my current IB equals to 0. That means two resistances R1 and R2 seems are connected in series. Which means that current flowing through resistance R1, that is I1, and current flowing through resistance I2, both will be same, that is my current I1 will be equal to I2. And suppose I am saying that current I, as my current IB equals to 0. So this is very interesting analysis part, and this can also support for the change of the transistor. Means it makes my circuit or it makes my analysis independent to beta. This is interesting. Makes the analysis independent to beta, which is very interesting. So generally, till now we have discussed three biasing methods: fixed bias, emitter bias, and self bias. And we have applied a unique mechanism. First, we apply KVL to the input loop. We have determined the input current IB, on the basis of which we have calculated the value of IC and IE. Then we have applied the KVL to the output loop, okay, and apply the DC load line analysis and all. But over here, if my IB equals to 0, so in this general philosophy, one can think about that my IC will also be 0, because till now we have discussed that my IC equals to beta times of IB, but we have to use some another method to solve such type of problem, and there is hardly variation of 10% in the results that we will see in the numerical session. So let us see this method in detail. And we are assuming that our condition beta time beta multiplied by RE should be greater than and equals to 10 times of R2, that this condition is satisfied. Okay, then how to proceed? So let me draw the circuit first. And in fact, I am interested in the DC current circuit, therefore I am drawing simply the DC current circuit. So this is my VCC, resistance R1, resistance R2. This is my node, and suppose I am the voltage of this node is VB because this is connected at the base terminal, RC and RE. And I am representing the currents also. So current flowing through, this is I1, current flowing through, this is my I2. Over here my base current IB, but this will be equal to 0 for approximate analysis. So for approximate analysis, current IB equals to 0, therefore I1 will be equal to I2 equals to say I, and current flowing through here is IC, current flowing through here is IE, voltage across here is VCE, voltage across here is VBE, and suppose again I am saying that this is my voltage VE. So generally you can see that VE is nothing but voltage across this resistance. So VE will be equal to simply IE into RE. Okay, so if my IB equals to 0, I want to calculate the value of this VB. What is the value of VB? Okay, so it is nothing but voltage across resistance R2. This is voltage across resistance R2. So again, apply voltage division rule. Again, apply voltage division rule over here. So it says that my VB, that is voltage across resistance R2, will be equal to R2 multiplied by overall voltage. So R2 multiplied by VCC divided by addition of the two series resistances. So this is my VB. If I am say assuming that my diode is made up from silicon, and as you know that J is forward bias, so value of VBE will be 0.7 volt. With vector analysis, I can term it as VBE equals to VB minus VE. So I can easily calculate the value of VE. Therefore, my VE will be equal to VB minus VBE. We have just calculated the value of VB. So I am putting over here, my VE will be equal to R2 into VCC divided by resistance R1 plus resistance R2 minus VBE. So this is my emitter voltage VE. Second, you can check, we have just calculated over here that the value of VE, that is my VE equals to IE into RE. So from this relation, I can easily calculate the value of emitter current IE, and it is simply my VE divided by RE. So for a given value of emitter resistance RE, I can easily calculate the value of VE. And if you can recall, there is a formula that IE will be equal to IB plus IC, and if somehow this component is zero, that means IC will approximately, or in fact will equal to IE only. So you can check, we have indirectly calculated the value of emitter current, which will be equal to my collector current. And now I can solve anything. Apply KVL to the output loop. Apply KVL to the output loop for further analysis. So it will be my VCC minus RC into IC minus VCE minus RE into IC equals to 0. Or my characteristic equation is VCE equals to VCC minus IC times of RC plus RE. So in fact, if by putting now value of IC over here, one can easily calculate the value of VCE. Now I am interested to calculate the value of VC. What is the value of VC? So I can apply vector analysis over here. VCE equals to VC minus VE. Therefore, the value of VC equals to VCE plus VE. VC we have just calculated from this relation. In fact, this is my characteristic equation. So from characteristic equation, we have just calculated. And VE we have calculated in the initial phase. So one can easily calculate this value. Now, in fact, if somebody want to say that what is my VBC, so VBC will be termed as simply VBC equals to VB minus VC. So now we can put all these components. VB we have calculated VCC times R2 divided by R1 plus R2 and minus this component VCE minus VE. So these are the all components which we have determined. Now what will happen if there is a condition of saturation? Okay, so let's see the saturation analysis. So saturation analysis will be similar. That means I have to calculate the value of IC saturation, and in ideal case we will take VC equals to 0. So in this situation, suppose again considering the same case, similar case, and once again I am interested in the output loop, therefore not preparing the input loop in detail. VCE equals to 0, so saturation current will flow. RC, RE plus VCC. Therefore, my IC set will be equals to VCC divided by RC plus RE. That is my saturation current. We have to check the stability factor of this configuration also. We have seen that this is a general formula which we have used, stability against the reverse saturation current. And as this circuit is independent to beta, you can check this analysis is independent to beta. So for such situation, okay, the beta term can be removed and the stability factor is my 1. So this configuration is best suited for the amplification purpose. Okay, this approximate analysis is best suited. Okay, so thank you.